गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल रीड क्लास 10 मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर 8 दैट इंट्रोडक्शन टू ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सम स्पेसिफिक एंगल्स ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोस। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ दिस मेजर्स विल हेल्प इन डिफरेंट प्रॉब्लम और हाउ वी यूज इन डिफरेंट नंबर्स लाइक Now, we have two terms, root 3 by 2 into root 3 by 2, and another one is 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. So, we will multiply these two and these two. After that, we will add the result. Here, root 3 by 2 into root 3 by 2. Numerator multiplies numerator, that becomes 3. 2 into 2 is 4. Similarly, 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 is 1 by 4. Now we have to add this root 3, it is 3 by 4 and 1 by 4. Here LCM is 4, numerator is 3 plus 1 is 4 by 4, which gives 1. So value of the statement sin 60 into cos 30 plus sin 30 into cos 60 is 1. Next, we'll take one more example. BQ is 3 cm and PR is 6 cm. Find angle P and angle R. How to find these angles? How we use the table of that trigonometric ratios to find the measure of angle P and angle R. Since it is not given this side QR, first we have to find the measure of this QR. PQR is right angle triangle. If we apply Pythagoras formula on this triangle PQR, then we can find easily the length QR here. In triangle PQR, QR square, that is base square, is equal to hypotenuse square minus perpendicular square. That is PR square minus PQ square by Pythagoras formula. This is equal to PR square 6 square minus 3 square, that is 36 minus 9 is 27. here, QR square is 27. And QR will be root of 27. That is 3, root 3 cm. It is 3, root 3 cm. Now, if we take angle P, we can write here cos P. Cos P becomes adjacent by hypotenuse, that is 3 by 6. Cos P is 1 by 2. This cos P is 1 by 2 present in cos 60 degree. Cos 60 is 1 by 2. So value of P is 60 degree. We can find this value of P at 60 degree. If we take sine ratio for this angle P, it is 3 root 3 by 6. If we do not find this Q1 and directly we find this cos P, we will get 60 degree for this angle P. If it is 60, it becomes 30 degree according to angle sum property. If you find Q1 here 3 root 3, we can use sin 60 or sin P, that is QR by PR. Sin P is QR, 3 root 3 by PR is 6 is root 3 by 2. The sin P is sin 60. Then P will be 60 degree. On this ratio, we are getting P is 60 degree. On this cos ratio, we are getting P is 60 degree. In every ratio, we will get the same result. So, you can choose any ratio to find the measure of the angles. Okay? Next, we will take one more example here. If it is given sin A minus B is 1 by 2, sin A minus B is 1 by 2, and cos A plus B is 1 by 2, and cos A plus B is 1 by 2. Here one restriction is there, that angle A is greater than angle B, and this A plus B is lying between 0 degree and 90 degree, and 0 degree less than A plus B is less than 90 degree. Two conditions are there, angle A is greater than angle B, and this 0 A plus B is lying between 0 and 90 degree. Maybe A plus B equal to 90, maybe it is less than 90 degree. We have to find the measure of A and B. Then find A and B. So the statements what are given here, we have to obtain the relation between A and B. After obtaining their relation, we will make them equations as the form of linear equation in two variables. Then we will follow one of the method to solve that equations. Here, it is given sin A minus B is equal to 1 by 2. Now we have to choose on which angle sine ratio becomes 1 by 2. It is sine 30 degree. This implies sine A minus B is equal to sine 30 degree. If sine A minus B is sine 30, then A minus will equal to 30 degree. This implies A minus B equal to 30. Check this statement as equation 1. Again, from next element. That cos A plus B is 1 by 2. Cos A plus B is 1 by 2. Now we have to choose the angle on which cos ratio becomes 1 by 2. That is cos 30 degree. Cos 60 degree. That is cos A plus B is cos 60 degree. This implies A plus B is equal to 60. Take this statement as equation 2. Now equation 1 and equation 2 are in the form of linear equation and two variables where A and B are considered as the variable. By following
tan 65 degree by cot
25 tens. How to evaluate 1065 by what's 25? Since it is not mentioned that 65 and 25 degree of trigonometric ratios in our chapter here, not mentioned in the table. So how to solve it? How to find its value? It is not known for us what will be the value of 1065. If it is given 1060, directly we can put root 3. But 1065 is not mentioned. So how to solve it? First we have to check whether the angles which are given, like 65 and 25, are complementary or not. That means whether the sum is 90 or not. 65 and 25, they are added up to 90. So this 65 and 25 are complementary. Next we will choose the trigonometric ratios, or we will check this 10 and cot, whether they are complementary or not. Yes, 10 and cot also complementary, 65 and 25 also complementary. So now we will process here. Here it is given 10 65 degree by cot 25 degree. Either we will convert this 10 into cot or cot into 10 according to complementary angles. We know 10 90 minus theta is cot theta, or cot 90 minus theta is tan theta. We have to change any one of this 10 or cot. Let we change this cot. We will convert this cot into 10. In the numerator it is present 1065 degree, but in the denominator if we want to change cot 25, we can write here 10 here cot 90 minus 65 degree. This is equal to 10 65 by cot 90 minus theta. Look, 90 minus 65 is 25. In place of 25, it is written 90 minus 65. Cot 90 minus theta is 10 theta. So it can be written as 10 65 degree. 10 65 by 10 65 is 1. We obtain the value 1 for this 1065 by cot 25. Next, if sin 3a equal to cos a minus 26. Is acute angle. Find the value of A. Here it is given sin 3a is cos a minus 26. This 3a is an acute angle. The value of 3a is less than 90 degree. Then we have to find the value of A. It is given sin 3a equal to cos a minus 26. Now it is observed in the left side the ratio sin is present, but in right side it is present cos. First we make both sides with same ratio. We make same ratio in both sides of the statement. So let's we change this sin into cos. How to change it? Sin 3a can be written as cos 90 minus 3. Just consider this 3a is theta. Now sin, this cos 90 minus theta is sin theta. So in place of sin theta we can put cos 90 minus theta. This is equal to cos a minus 26. Now we can remove cos from left and right side of the equation. It remains 90 minus 3a is a minus 26. Next, this minus 3 comes this side, 26 comes this side. 90 plus 26 a plus 3a. It is 116 is 4a. 4a is 116. This implies a is 116 by 4. That is 29. A is 29 here. Now we'll discuss about trigonometric identities. Let right angle triangle ABC is here, where angle B is 90 degrees. What will be sine theta if angle C is considered as theta? Sine theta. Sine theta is opposite side of hypotenuse, that is AB by AC. If sine theta is AB by AC, then sine square theta will be AB square by AC square. When we find cos of this angle theta, that cos theta is adjacent side by hypotenuse, that is BC by AC. Cos theta is BC by AC, then cos square theta will be BC square by AC square. If we add both the equation, that sin square theta and cos square theta, adding both the equations 1 and 2. Here sin square theta plus cos square theta is AB square by AC square plus BC square by AC square. Left side of both the equations are written here, sin square theta plus cos square theta. Right side of the equations also written, a square by c square plus b c square by a c square. We can take the LCM as a c square. The numerator it is a b square plus b c square. Here a b square plus b c square. A b square plus b c square becomes a c square by Pythagoras formula. It can be written as AC square by AC square. This is equal to 1. Therefore, sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. It is the identity. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. Similarly, we can prove here. Tan square theta plus 1 is sec square theta, and cot square theta plus 1 is cosec square theta. Sec square theta plus cos square theta is 1. Tan square theta plus 1 is sec square theta, and cot square theta plus 1 is cosec square theta. Now we'll use all these identities to prove some statements there. Now statement is given as that tan theta by 1 minus cos theta plus cot theta by 1 minus tan theta, which is equal with 1 plus sec theta into cosec theta. We have to prove the statement here. How to prove it? First, we will take the left side of the statement and we will show the right side. Here it is given tan theta by 1 minus cot theta plus cot theta by 1 minus tan theta. It is taken the left side of the statement. Here, it is present two ratios, tan and cot. We have to convert all these ratios in the form of sine and cos. Tan theta can be written as sine theta by cos theta. Tan theta is sine theta by cos theta. By 1 minus cos theta. Cot theta is cos theta by sine theta. Tan theta is sine theta by cos theta and cot theta is cos theta by sine theta. Plus cot theta is cos theta by sine theta. 1 minus tan theta is sine theta by cos theta. Now we have to process in the denominator to take LCM and find the subtract. It is sine theta by cos theta. Here the LCM of mod and sine theta will be sine theta. Here it is present sine theta minus cos theta. Plus numerator it is cos theta by sine theta. Here it is LCM cos theta. It's cos theta minus sine theta. Now sine theta by cos theta divided sine theta minus cos theta by sine theta. Sine theta will multiply sine theta gives sine square theta. The denominator it is cos theta into sine theta minus cos theta. Plus cos theta into cos theta is cos square theta. It is sine theta into cos theta minus sine theta. This becomes here in the denominator it is present sine theta minus cos theta. Here it is present cos theta minus sine theta. So we have to make them equal here. Sin square theta by cos theta into sin theta minus cos theta. If we change this cos theta minus sin theta in the form sin theta minus cos theta, then we have to change the symbol present here. This plus becomes minus. Yeah, it is taken the common this minus sign. It is cos square theta by sin theta into sin theta minus cos theta. Now the LCM of both the denominator is sin theta into cos theta into sin theta minus cos theta. When this LCM divided the denominator gives sin theta into sin square theta becomes sin cube theta minus LCM divided denominator gives cos theta into cos square is cos cube theta. Now it is in the form a cube minus b cube, which gives a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. That is sin theta minus cos theta into sin square theta plus sin theta into cos theta plus cos square theta divided sin theta into cos theta into sin theta minus cos theta. Here sin theta minus cos theta and sin theta minus cos theta will be cancelled. In the numerator, sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1 plus sin theta into cos theta. Divided sin theta cos theta. Here, this denominator is common for both 1 and this sin theta cos theta. We can write here 1 by sin theta cos theta plus sin theta cos theta by sin theta cos theta. 1 by sin theta cos theta can be written as 1 by sin into 1 by cos. It is 1 by sin theta into 1 by cos theta plus sin theta cos theta divided sin theta cos theta gives 1. 1 by sin theta is cosec theta. 1 by cos theta is sec theta plus 1. It is RHS. Here RHS is taken in the left side of the statement and we got RHS. It is proved.